Hey everybody, this is Perch. How much does paper matter in comics? Now, here's where I'll do 10 minutes of video on a topic that I always think will get like 5 views. I mean, it's like if you were to pick, like, what are boring topics that people could do for comic videos, paper would have to be, up there, right? I mean, the paper weight. But paper is a topic people think about in comics. It's one that comes up a lot, and it often comes up in kind of unusual ways. It comes up in the paper quality is garbage, why is the ink coming off in my hands, or why don't the comic publishers go to cheaper paper so the comic price can go down? And kind of the debate rages there. Nothing really changes. I remember, and you're going to have to take a journey with me if you were alive back then, there was a moment where the direct market started putting better paper, the publishers started putting better paper out for some comics. I remember this, for me, the one I remember it hit first was Power Pack. Now, this had happened before with, I think, some of the Epic comics, and there have been plenty of different comics. And I think everybody has their own memory of when it was better. But I remember Power Pack came out. And it was weird because Power Pack, was being billed as a kind of a special format, different paper, and for the direct market. But I remember going into Walden Books and seeing this comic there, and it having nicer paper. And it was like, well, this isn't a comic shop, but this paper is nicer. And it was funny, too, because I remember, in addition to that, I think it was Fantastic Four X-Men had the nicer paper as well. Not the recent one, the one from the 80s. And I remember the coloring, like, I was initially turned off. I remember picking up this thing and looking at this comic, and the paper was nicer. But as a result, the printing, the colors looked more day glow. The colors looked more vibrant. And as a result, it was like the comic characters themselves were coming across kind of like these nostalgic parodies you see of the 80s, kind of where, like you saw in Wonder Woman 84, you know, everything was kind of hyper-colored, and that reminds me, there was a shirt called Hyper-Color, where it changed color based on heat. I remember, like, in my school, people were really excited about that. Like, these shirts were, like, so cool, because they changed colors. And then the kids, discovered that, like, you know, certain parts of your body, like under your arms, like your armpits, get hot, and then that's not a good look. If you've got this shirt, it's like this, it's changing color in the wrong spots. And many, many other problems beyond that. You can imagine all the uncomfortable situations. I did not own one of these shirts. I remember being jealous of like, ah, damn, this kid's got this hyper-color shirt and his Zeke Cavaricci pants, and he's looking cool, and I don't, stuck here with my jeans. Anyway, sorry. Like 95% of the audience is like, what? It's like Joe from that Linearverse video. Like, what are you talking about? Anyway, paper. So, you know, it's kind of one of those monkey paw like things. I remember that wishing that the paper would be better, and then getting the paper better and discovering that not only is the price kind of going up, but also the colors look all funky now, and it wasn't as good a thing. And now I find myself kind of wishing for that cheaper newsprint. Probably not because I like the paper, but because my mind, my memory is of the great comics I read on newsprint. So now I'm like, I wish you could go back to newsprint again, because I got better comics, you know, when I was reading on newsprint. But if it was done that way today, if suddenly, you know, comics being printed on newsprint, we'd still have the same comics that are being printed today. The content wouldn't magically improve just because the paper quality changed. And then I did that other video, relatively recently, talking about how if you lowered the price, if you went to newsprint for comics, if you suddenly cheapened up the paper, that you probably wouldn't see a drop in price. And that seemed to really frustrate people because they're like, no, of course you'd see a drop in price because the paper would cost less. And it's like, that's a nice idea, but what makes you think that Marvel or Disney or DC or any of the, what makes you think they would pass along the savings to the consumer? Why would you assume that? If you have a business model today that says that you can, you know, push out Excalibur at 30,000 copies, why would you assume at you know, whatever it is, $3.99, why would you assume going to newsprint and, you know, you, the publisher, cutting, you know, 40 cents off your costs, why would you assume that you would then suddenly go, well, we're making these for less now. Let's charge less. Yeah, I mean, if there's one thing I know about Disney, it's that they definitely look to the consumer. And if there's a way for them to give a price break to their audience, they will take it every time. That's definitely Disney's track record. That's sarcasm, by the way. I'm going to start labeling this stuff better because I apparently have a very dry sense of humor, which is, I guess, true. I've heard that before, but it's going too dry for people. We're also getting close to April Fool's, so everybody thinks I'm just full of pranks all the time. Man, April Fool's. I've got my prank set up for April Fool's. It's going to be, you will not expect it. It'll be fun. So overall, paper. I do think it's tough to live in this world of, you know, do you want it? On one hand, there's a lot of criticism about, and not as much anymore, but just ink coming off on your hands, particularly where Marvel is concerned. At the same time saying, hey, let's cheapen the paper up further to give a price break, which probably wouldn't happen even if they did it. So where does that leave us? I mean, you know, practically, I think that, you know, one aspect we don't talk about very much, and I don't have the answer to this, but it's something to consider, is who prints where. And what I mean by that is, if you switch to a certain type of paper, does that improve or decrease your ability to print comics, to actually get comics out there? There's one factor about newsprint that may or may not be true, again, I don't know, is have many of the printers move to different paper types to the point that newsprint is kind of feeling like more of a niche product, where it wasn't, say, you know, 10, 15 years ago. If more people have moved to higher quality paper, then your costs and your availability may actually go down. Or sorry, your availability may go down, your cost might go up if you go to a type of paper that they don't have. Now, suddenly, if you're printing, you know, millions of copies of comics through this stuff, then, you know, you'd build back up that efficiency. But it the whole thing is messy. I guess my bigger point, we can't control the costs. You, me, none of the people listening to this right now can control the actual costs of what's happening. But you as the customer and the consumer do have a say in it. It's like, it's number one, how important is paper to you? Does this impede your reading experience? Do you enjoy it? What's the quality of paper? What's the lowest quality of paper before you start saying, nope, I'm not reading this. It's printed on toilet paper. I'm out. At what point does it start to become a big impact to you? And then separately to your wallet, what kind of price break are you looking for? Because chances are, again, this was a point I made in the other video. If you're looking at the comic and you're saying it's $3.99, I would expect to pay, you know, $1.99. I want $2 off this comic. I basically want the price to go in half. Then paper is not going to get you there. Not even close. You've got to start talking about, you know, scale of distribution, other things. I think it is reasonable to ask the question, hey, why is digital pricing same as paper printed? That is a good question. A fine question, in fact. But, you know, how does that play into things for you? And then, if you have been collecting or reading comics for a long period of time, where has it been good for you? Does this resonate with you? Or do you remember this moment where the paper quality got better and your feeling about the comic got worse, where you actually felt like that going to a higher quality paper made the comic somehow worse, either because of the coloring or because of the, you know, flipping through it? I know some indies who went to a much heavier stock of paper to the point that it just now felt unpleasant flipping through it. It felt like I was flipping through kind of a car brochure as opposed to an actual comic, and it didn't feel right. So what kind of intangibles are there for you? How much does paper impact you? That's the core question here. So there we go. 10 minutes on an extremely boring topic, paper, but it is one that, you know, is very relevant to comics. I mean, God help us all if I bring up the idea of like, hey, what if there was no paper at all and everything was to go digital? And like, suddenly I see like people with pitchforks appearing outside my window. So paper clearly still matters, at least at some level for all of us. So how much for you? Let me know in the comments below kind of your thoughts about it. Hopefully starting a bit of a conversation around, you know, what's possible, what's not. And I think for people who are crowdfunding, you know, it gives them some insight too. You know, where should they go? You know, if you're going to print a comic through Kablam, for example, as I was seeing just a couple days ago, you've got a bunch of paper options there. You got a bunch of options for, you know, the cover, and which is, I guess, a whole other question. What kind of stock are you expecting on the cover? These are all kind of pieces that for many of us, we're just reading comics, we tend to not think about on a regular basis. We just read the comic, but it is the stuff we're holding in our hands, so it does matter. So there you go. Leave a comment below. Let me know your thoughts on all this. Like and subscribe. Contact information in the description. And thanks for listening.